Hello everyone, today we are diving deep into a crucial aspect of cosmetic formulation that is often overlooked, calculating ingredient percentages. Stick around to the end because this knowledge will truly elevate your formulation game. Alright, let's get started. Have you ever looked at a product label and wondered what those percentages next to each ingredient means? Well, today we're going to demystify it all. Whether you are tweaking an existing recipe or creating a new one from scratch, getting your percentages right is the key to consistent high quality results. First and first, why percentages? Well, it's simple. Using percentages allows formulators to scale up or down their batches easily. So whether you are making a small 100 gram test batch or producing 10,000 kg for retail, the consistency remains the same. Now let's dive into the math. Don't worry, I promise it's not as intimidating as it sounds. Say you're formulating a face cream with 5 ingredients. Start by determining the total weight of your batch. Let's take 100 grams for easy calculation. If your formula states that rose water is 50%, that simply means you take 50% of 100 grams, which is 50 grams of rose water. Here is a pro tip. Always ensure that your percentages add up to 100%. This is a fundamental check to ensure your calculations are on track. Now, let's talk about some ingredients that are often used in tiny amounts like preservatives and fragrances. You might see them listed as 0.5% or even 0.1%. Even though these percentages are small, they are mighty. Getting them right is essential for product efficacy and safety. For a 100 gram batch, 0.1 translates to a mere 0.1 gram. So, precision is key. Alright, for those wanting to scale up, the principles remains the same. If you're making a 500 gram batch and your ingredient is 2%, you will use 10 gram of that ingredient. It's all about scaling proportionately. But wait, before you go and start formulating, I've got a bonus tip. Always double check your calculations, especially when scaling up. It is a simple step, but it can save you from making costly mistakes. Remember, the beauty of understanding percentages in formulation is that it grants you the freedom to be flexible, experimental, and precise all at the same time. So next time you're formulating, you will do so with greater confidence and accuracy. Now, before we wrap up, I've got to remind you all to hit that subscribe button and tap the bell icon so you never miss out on gems like this. For all my dedicated formulators wanting to dive even deeper and learn how to craft retail-grade beauty products, don't forget to visit stablecosmeticformulas.com. It's packed with a plethora of information that's bound to take your formulation skill to the next level. Thanks for tuning in, and remember, the world of beauty formulation is vast and fascinating. Dive in, keep learning, and most importantly, have fun while you are at it. Until next time.